Last week, America was forced to learn who Sidney Powell was, and it was a rude awakening because this lawyer, this person with a law degree, is talking about how Hugo Chavez is responsible for Joe Biden winning and everything. Well, look, if you have been wondering along the way, as we've been going through all of what passes for American politics over the past few years, is there a line for the Trump camp? We apparently might have found it, because Sidney Powell has been ejected from the campaign bus, which then backed up and then rolled over her. The Trump campaign on Sunday sought to distance itself from attorney Sidney Powell after she made a series of increasingly convoluted and baseless allegations of widespread national election fraud. That's not exactly why they're doing it, because they're all doing that. But Powell, who also represents former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn, had appeared with campaign lawyers at press events as recently as last week. It's really fast. This is important that we not skip over this, because you remember this little clip?
This is an elite strike force team that is working on behalf of the president and the campaign to make sure that our constitution is protected.
Okay, so that was funny at the time, but as I read this next graphic, bear in mind, the person hovering directly behind Jenna Ellis is Sidney Powell. So remember that, as they put out a campaign statement saying, Sidney Powell is practicing law on her own. She is not a member of the Trump legal team. She is also not a lawyer for the president in his personal capacity, according to Rudy Giuliani, who was also standing on the stage with her at that thing. Now, in a statement issued to CBS News, Ms. Powell said that she understood the statement from Mr. Giuliani and Jenna Ellis, and that she would still be filing a lawsuit related to her allegations of voter fraud on her own. She seems a little bit confused, which again, I sort of understand, because as you can see in this photo from that same event, she not only stood behind Jenna Ellis, she addressed the nation with Rudy Giuliani, with Jenna Ellis, as a member in good standing as of that moment of the elite strike force. And now it's like, Sidney who? Powell what? We don't know anything about her. You did.
You know, you gotta wonder though, like Giuliani just melting into tar, like going down like the penguin in Batman wasn't enough, or standing in front of a landscaping company going, the polls, you know, like, or standing next to Eric or whatever he was doing, like that wasn't enough. No. But suddenly Sidney Powell, and we know what's so funny about this is I feel like Sidney Powell wasn't fired because she said nutso stuff, right? She said that there was gonna be a biblical lawsuit filed in Georgia shortly. She said Hugo Chavez rigged the election in some, you know, inception, you know, of South America, some socialist inception, which I'm all about, BT dubs. That's what we're here doing, or what I'm doing. But like she said all these crazy things, but what's so funny is she didn't make it enough about the president. And didn't make it enough about Trump. And like going back and being like, why have people been fired? Why was Giuliani fired way back when? It's because he started to get on his own high horse and started to make it about him, right? Sidney Powell starts going off saying random stuff, but she never kept coming back to like this president, his strength, his integrity, his economy, like the way that every other sycophant does. She started going off the deep end. So I'm feeling like it wasn't even that she said outlandish stuff. It was just that she didn't make it enough about Trump. And also, let's be real, she's a four, okay? And she doesn't have the scarves that you know, Dr. Birx has. If you get some scarves, maybe you'll look better, cover up the face. Like this, you know, it's gotta be something petty. That's why she was fired. It wasn't because she was just spewing lies.
Yeah, Trump thinks of her the way Hassan thinks of Dax Shepard as of today. look, you might be right. Yeah, it's not just loyalty to the president. That's the shorthand we use. That means not going against him. But it's not just loyalty to the president. It's obsession with the president, which has to go beyond that.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.